Thank you. We haven't got a lot of time tonight, but we'd like to do before we go something from our last album. This is called 2112.
Of their own instruments and have never been brought down by harsh criticism. And believe me, they got a lot of it. Rush pinpoint a time that was musically better, grander, and only few bands of today carry that same message. Although being more known for their early days of prog, Rush developed over the years into many unique and different styles of music, forming from their progressive tone to a more mainstream style of music. Although some Rush fans tend to ignore the 80s and 90s side of Rush, I don't. I think it's just as good as their work in the 70s. I've never disliked a Rush album, and despite my favourites being of course the prog days, I still love all their other albums. As far as I'm concerned, Rush have never put a foot wrong. It's just called experimenting. Rush to me stands for respect, uniqueness, speed, meaning complex, and heroin. Why heroin? Because Rush are like a drug to me.
Like a drug to me. Like my own personal brand of heroin.
Hell no. Just no. Just no. So, naturally being a hardcore Rush fan, as soon as I heard that their new album had finally been released, I physically shat myself. And here it is, Clockwork Angels. And it's not just an album, it's a concept album. And it is brilliant. In the week that I've owned the album, I must have listened to it from start to finish about 10 times already. People may say that you can hear elements of their old styles of music and even some of their old songs, but it's all deliberate, just like Bastille Day appearing in Headlong Flight. But aside from the brilliant music, I'd just like to take a few moments to talk about the concept art. It's very nice, as you can see, very nice, and it even has an Easter egg there, as you can see, that says 2112. Well, it wouldn't digital, so that's very nice. It's very cool. But of course, it differs, you know, a lot from the single. So here we go. Here's the single, and yeah, as you can see, it's a lot different. If you go on Wiki before the album was released, I don't know if they've changed it. I haven't looked. But if you go on Wiki and type in Clockwork Angels, it come up with this picture, but instead of Caravan and BU2B, it said Clockwork Angels. So when the album was released, I was expecting this, and of course, that's the back picture for anyone who's interested. As for the actual album, like I said, it's a lot, it's you know, different, it's quite nice, like I said, it's got the Easter egg of 2112. The back is literally just clockwork, as you can see in the tracks, and inside it comes with a load of pictures to help describe what's happening in the lyrics, and of course, as you'd expect in any Rush album, there's the lyrics of the songs. But yeah, in general, it's just a really, really good album, and I don't want to say anything or go into detail about the actual music because it will ruin it for you. So just listen to it. I know some people have actually put it online, so watch it while you can, or if not, do what I did and buy the thing. I got the fan pack, so I got it early. But yeah, so awesome, absolutely awesome, brilliant. Hope they make another one, and listen to the album. I know I keep saying that, but it is really worth the money, it's worth the time, it's worth the wait as well, so definitely give it a watch, listen rather, and I shall see you in another Screen Hopper movie review, which should be out shortly. It's just in the process of editing, it's quite a long one, so yep, take care, and I shall see you on the road. Take care. Stars winking through the canvas. The caravan.